laminated characters. In this laminated characters, now habitat. In which places these plants are grown? This habitat. In these habitats, most of the plants are grown as mesophytes. Some are aquatic plants. Aquatic plants, best example is menta. Next one is xerophytic characters. Xerophytic plant, that is roseberries. Next, habit. Either these plants are herbs, shrubs, or trees. Like this habit, including in the habit character. In this habit, most of the plants are smooth to touch. Which plants are smooth to touch? Those plants are called as herbs. These plants are grown as herbs. Those herbs are either annual herbs or perennial herbs. Then some plants are grown as shrubs. One and only plant is grown as climbing shrub. Example is Marianda. This Marianda plant is grown as a climbing shrub in the Lamiaceae family. Next one is Brazil tree. A plant is grown as Brazil, grown like tree, that is Hippis. Okay, this is about the habitat and habit of the Lamiaceae family plants. Next, we will discuss about the vegetative characters of the Lamiaceae family. In this vegetative characters, root is, which type of root system is present in this family? Exactly, taproot system. Why? Because this entire plants are dicotyledons. That's why it has taproot system. But in Mentha arvensis, we observe the adventitious roots because it is grown as aquatic plant. Okay, then going to the stem. In the stem, stem is aerial. It is aerial, erect, aerial, erect. Rarely subaerial plants, example Mentha. Rarely subaerial plants, example Mentha. And the stem, overall the Lamiaceae plants has on the stem roots, on the stem some small, short, hairy like structures also present. See the stem. This is small, white, hair like structures. These hairy like structures are present on the stem. This stem has four faces. That's why this stem is quadrangular. Going to this point, this stem is hairy. See this, hairy, small, short, white, hairy like structures on the stem. Then the stem is quadrangular and it is very aromatic. Very aromatic nature, sweet smelling. Then in this Lamiaceae family, a plant has rhizome. Stem is modified as rhizome. Example is Plectranthus. Example is Plectranthus rhizome. This rhizome is used as vegetative reproduction. Next, leaf structure. Leaf characters. This leaf is, see this stigma, this twigger. In this leaf structure, leaves are simple. Leaf has petiole. It is petiole. This is leaf. Leaf lamina. Leaf has petiole. This leaves are arrangement. This leaf phyllotaxy is opposite decusset phyllotaxy. Opposite decusset phyllotaxy means this is opposite decusset phyllotaxy. On stem, on main axis, every node has opposite leaves. On this opposite leaves, above, another leaf pairs also present. This type of phyllotaxy is known as opposite decusset phyllotaxy. Okay, leaf is very simple leaf. Some leaves have dentate structure like this. It is entire dentate structure. This slits. This is dentate structure. Entire dentate structure is observed in the leaves. On the leaves also hairy like structures present. Leaves also hairy like structures also present. Next, in coleus, leaves are variegated. This is entire dentate structure. See this ma? This entire leaf has dentate like this. So many slits are observed in the leaves. It is dentate structure. Commonly leaves are simple leaves, but in some leaves has dentate structure in entire leaf. This is dentate structure. Example, coleus. This coleus leaves are very beautiful appearance with variegated leaves. Variegated nothing but various colors of the leaves. Okay. Once, see this topic. Simple. Petiole is present, but stipules are absent. That's why extipule. Ovate in structure, but in some plants, entire dentate structure, hairy, and the leaves also hairy present. Aromatic. Very aromatic. Next, variegated leaves on the coleus. Okay. This is the about vegetative characters of the Lamiaceae family. Students, Lamiaceae floral characters. In this Lamiaceae floral characters, first we will discuss about the inflorescence. In the Lamiaceae family, three types of inflorescence is present. Those are the thyrsus, verticillator and catkin. These three types of inflorescence are present in the Lamiaceae family. Thyrsus example is Asimum species, all species of the Asimum. Verticillator example is Leucas aspera. In Telugu, it is called as Tummi. Then catkin inflorescence. Catkin inflorescence example is Coleus bloomi. Now, we will discuss about the definitions and what is the inflorescences, thyrsus and verticillator inflorescence. Okay, next going to the thyrsus inflorescence. In this thyrsus inflorescence, we have to observe in the Asimum species, inflorescence peduncle is indefinite, unlimited. That growth is indefinite growth. On this peduncle, dicarsial cymose inflorescence is present. Such type of inflorescence is known as thyrsus inflorescence. Example is Asimum, all species. Then verticillator. Verticillator is one type of the mixed inflorescence. In mixed inflorescence, three inflorescence types are present. It is discussed in, studied in your intermediate level. It is one type of mixed inflorescence. Verticillator is. This verticillator inflorescence is ball-shaped specialized structure. It is ball-shaped specialized structure or false walled inflorescence is known as verticillator. For this verticillator example is Leucas aspera. Then, going to the flower. Characters about the flower. Flower has pedicel. If pedicel is present, if stalk is present, that is known as pedicellator. If stalk is absent to the flower, that is known as sessile flower. Then, bracteate. Bracts are present to the flower, but bracteolates are absent. That is, it is indicates as EBRL. EBRL means E. bracteolate means bracteolates are absent. Then this flower is complete flower means entire floral parts like calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium are present in the flower. That's why it is complete flower. And also bisexual flower. Both male, female sex organs are present in the flower. That's why it is bisexual flower. Then it is zygomorphic flower. Why it is zygomorphic flower? Already we known in the classification. Because this flower petals are modified as bilobed or bilipped. 4 plus 1 in arrangement or 2 plus 2 in arrangement. That's why it is zygomorphic flower. But in Mentha arvensis, in Mentha it is actinomorphic flower. Okay. Then this flower has 5 sepals, 5 petals. That's why it is pentamerous flower and also hypogynous flower. Calyx. In the calyx, sepals are present. These sepals are 5 in numbering. These are gamosepals. That means fused together themselves. Okay. 5 in numbering. In acimum, these 5 sepals are arranged as 1 plus 4 in arrangement. Then in Salvia officinalis, bilobed means 2 plus 3 in arrangement of the sepals are occurs in the Salvia. Then commonly veins are present in the leaves, but we have to observe the veins in the sepals of the Lamiaceae family. This calyx is a valvate aestivation, mostly valvate aestivation. In rare some cases imbricate aestivation is present. Then corolla. Corolla has 5 petals. These 5 petals are fused themselves. That's why it is gamopetalous. These petals are arranged as bilipped or bilabiated. Already I told about this bilabiated or bilipped phenomenon in the classification. Then these petals has imbricate aestivation. This bilipped or bilabiate number is a number of lobes in each lip varies in different species. That is, for example, in Leucas aspera, 2 plus 3 in arrangement of the petals, in upper lip 2, in lower lip 3, then Acimum species 4 plus 1 in arrangement of the petals, in Mentha arvensis 5 petals are fused together, but this entire petals are fused together appearance like 4 petals only. This is about the corolla. Androecium is male sexual part. In this androecium, mainly stamens and anthers are observed. Stamens are 4 in numbering. But in Salvia officinalis, only 2 stamens are present. Commonly in all plants has 4 in numbering of the stamens in Lamiaceae family. But only in Salvia, 2 stamens are present. These 4 stamens are not fused, I mean free, diadynamous stamens. Already we discussed about the what is diadynamous phenomenon in starting point. Diadynamous means stamens are 2 various in heights, 2 plus 2 in arrangement, that is diadynamous. Then these stamens are epipetalous. Epipetalous means stamens are fused to petals, that is known as epipetalous. Then anthers are diathecous and basifixed. This is diathecous. 2 chambers like this. This is diathecous and basifixed anthers. Then these anthers are introverts. And dehisce is longitudinal dehisce. This is about the androecium. In this androecium, main character is diadynamous. 4 stamens are free and epipetalous. Okay. Then in Salvia, but in Salvia only 2 stamens are present. How is the arrangement of the 2 stamens in Salvia? Now I will discuss. In salvia, only two stamens are present. In those two stamens, two anther lobes are present. These two anther lobes are widely separated and look like a lever, like this. This is salvia anthers arrangement. These two anther lobes are widely separated, look like a lever. It is lever. Lever means tula dandam, traso. Okay, it is look like a lever. On these two anther lobes, a connective is present. This is one anther lobe, this is another anther lobe. Upper anther lobe is a fertile lobe. Lower anther lobe is sterile lobe. In between these two anther lobe, anther lobes connective is present. This connective is always moves on the filament. Such arrangement is observed in the salvia. So, in this way, mechanism is occurs. This mechanism is known as lever. It is again discussed in the mechanism and pollination. Next, gynoecium. In this gynoecium, hypogynous flowers are present. Bicarpellary, syncarpus, two carpels are present. These two carpels are fused. That's why syncarpus. Bilacular, superior ovary. But commonly this gynoecium is a bicarpellary, syncarpus, bilacular, superior ovary. But during the development, this bilacular ovary is becomes into tetralacular. Once see this structure in this diagram. This is gynoecium. This is one lacule, this is one lacule. This is bilacular ovary. But when it is matured in stage, this bilacular ovary is becomes into tetralacular ovary. This bilacular is becomes into tetralacules. Okay, this is tetralacular ovary. Then in this placentation is seen as axial placentation. Style is, it is very 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 important character, that is gynobasic style. Gynobasic style defines, style is arised from the basal region of the ovary lobes. See this picture once. This is ovary, bilacular ovary. This is one lacule, this is another lacule. This is bilacular ovary. Gynobasic style means, style is arised from the bilacular basal region. Arised from the basal region of the bilacules. Simply saying about the gynobasic style, this style is arised, produced from the basal region, gynobasic. So, basal region of the gynoecium or basal region of the ovary lobes. This is known as gynobasic style. This style is bifid, by slits. This style is by slits. It is known as gynobasic style. It is formed from the basal region of the ovary lobes. Next, stigma. Style is gynobasic style. Gynobasic style means style is originated from the basal region of the ovary. This is ovary. This is style. Style is originated from the below region of the ovary lobes. It is known as gynobasic style. Next, stigma. Stigma is bifid. This is bifid stigma. Basal region of the or around the ovary, nectar glands are present. This is all over the topic of the Lamiaceae floral characters. Lamiaceae family, pollination through the insects, that is entomophily. In Lamiaceae family, we have to observe a specialized mechanism. Example is Salvia officinalis. That is pollination mechanism is lever mechanism. Lever mechanism. How is the continuation of the lever mechanism in this five steps. In the first step, in salvia officinalis, only two stamens are present. Those two stamens are dithecous. In these two stamens, half of the anther is fertile, half of the anther is sterile. Which lobe is towards the upper side, that is fertile. Which lobe is towards the lower side, that is sterile. See this picture. This is the two lobes of the anther. Upper side lobe is, anther lobe is fertile one. Lower side anther lobe is sterile one. In between these two lobes, a large connective is present. This is connective. A large connective is present. This connective is widely separated from one lobe to another lobe. Okay. This connective is always moves on the filament. It is filament. Connective is in between the fertile and sterile anther lobes for the separation of themselves. Then this connective is always freely moves on the filament. This is the second step. In the third step, the connective part bears the sterile portion. This is arranged transversely at the anterior of the corolla tube. This connective is located at the anterior part of the corolla tube, arranged as transversely. Connective part bears the sterile portion. It is arranged transversely at the anterior of the corolla tube. Next step is, when the insect is tries to enter into the flower, when the insect is tries to enter into the flower in the searching of the nectar, common nectar is located below region of the ovary. For this nectar searching by insect, sterile anther lobe, this one, sterile anther lobe is pushed. Sterile anther lobe is pushed. In this way, the fertile anther lobe is bended. Okay. Then, in the last step is, when bended of the anther lobe, pollen grains touch the backside of the insect. The same insect, in this way, pollination is occurs. This pollination mechanism is known as lever mechanism. Why? Because this connective is always moves on the filament free. It is connective in between the fertile and sterile anther lobes. It is like this entire structure is appearance like lever. That's why this mechanism is known as lever mechanism. Example is Salvia officinalis. When the insect is left over the flower, the same insect when visit the another flower in search of nectar, the stigma touches the pollen and laid back of it, and thus pollination is effected. This is lever mechanism. After pollination, fruit is developed from the flower. That means flower is becomes into fruit. Fruit is carcerulous. And also drupe type of fruits are present in the Lamiaceae family. Seed is non-endospermic seed. Today, this is entire topic, complete in detail topic of the Lamiaceae classification, vegetative characters, floral characters, pollination, after the pollination fruit formation and seed, and also economic importance of the Lamiaceae family. Okay, thank you.
Students, I'll give a small demonstration of Lamiaceae family Asinum sancta. This is Dicarcial cymose. It is Dicarcial cymose inflorescence. This is Thyrsus inflorescence. Thyrsus means it is Dicarcial cymose inflorescence means unlimited, indefinite peduncle. It is indefinite peduncle. On this peduncle, dicarcial cymose, dicarcial branches. Every peduncle given dicarcial. This is one branch, this is one branch. This is known as dicarsial cymose inflorescence. It is enlarged peduncle. This indefinite peduncle and this indefinite peduncle, two branches are present. These branches are known as dicarsial cymose branches. This entire inflorescence type is known as thyrsus inflorescence. Example, asimum. Next, I'll show calyx. In the asimum, calyx is modified as 4 plus 1 in arrangement. See this. This is flower. See this one. 4 plus 1. This is, it is larger. This is larger. It is one sepal only remaining. Here, 4 slits are observed. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. Clear? This is 4 plus and 1 arrangement of the sepals. In this sepals has veins like structure. These veins are clearly appearance in the outer tip. Okay, then going to the petals, students, see this flower. This is petals. 5 petals are present. These five petals are arranged as 4 plus 1 in arrangement. This is 4 plus 1 in arrangement. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. This is petals. Now, stamens. See this. 4 yellowish colored. These are the 4 yellowish colored stamens are present. Diadenomous stamens here. These 4 stamens are present. 1, 2, 3. 3 is here. Another one is here, back side. Okay. This is 4 stamens. It is known as diadenomous stamens. Here, next, gynoecium, clearly appearance. Thread-like structure here. See this. Only this one. Bislitted stigma. In apical region, 2 slits are observed. In this, it is styler. In apical region, it one. This one. Okay, this one, 2 slits are present, apical region of style, it is stigma, bifid stigma. Okay, then next I'll show the lacules. Commonly bilacular ovary, yes, but after maturation, during the maturation, this bilacules are modifies into tetralacule. Yes, I'll show the tetralacule in this demonstration. See this one. This is ovary. Before the maturation, ovary is bilacular. After the maturation, nothing but during the development of ovary, bilacular ovary is becomes into tetralacular ovary. in this demonstration 4 lacules. 1, 2, 3, 4. Keen observation here, 4 lacules are present. Okay. Bilacular ovary becomes into tetralacular ovary. This is small demonstration about the Asimum sanctum floral characters. Thank you so much for this video, students. Hope you all stay in home and safe. I hope you all understand this topic of Lamiaceae family entire characters. Thank you for your seeing this video. All of you stay in home and safe.